7:30 a.m.
Look up what 7:30 means, because I think you a little 7:30 too. That means crazy, baby.
Yeah, but crazy people don't really sleep. I mean, they actually kind of stay up all
I'll see you outside with the samurai sword, nigga. If you eat an alkaline food, you can fight with your hands.
Fight with my hands? I'm deadly with my hands. What are you talking about? You would rather have...
Just prove to me that an alkaline kills somebody. Prove it.
I'm going to get to your point. First of all, that piece about cancer, right, and acidity, what did you say?
There's two things. When you eat something, it's either going to be acidic or alkaline.
Right.
The acidic foods cause disease, mucus in your blood, and cancer.
Actually, cancer causes acidity. Acidity doesn't cause cancer. Cancer causes acidity. Acidity doesn't cause cancer. That's so we're clear. Cancer actually causes the acidity. The acidity doesn't actually cause the cancer. It doesn't work like that. Cancer doesn't work like that. I've studied cancer.
So if you have a newborn baby, right? As soon as they're born, back in the day, they would have lived thousands of years.
Back
as soon as they're born now, they give them a vaccine. They don't stand a fucking chance. 75.
Back in the day?
Yeah, before all this bullshit.
Okay, so were kids catching whooping cough back in the day?
All right, yeah, I can give you that.
Were kids catching
measles
back
in the day? I'm not going to say take the vaccine, though. You can't just say take the vaccine, my nigga.
Okay, so hold up.
A lot of people trying to rush this vaccine.
Hold on.
Do you believe that Bill Gates is trying to cause fucking population control? I want to see where your mind is at.
7:30. You obviously haven't been following my chat or my Instagram post. You probably just came in today. What you missed, like a bunch of other niggas who jump in and just start popping shit, is what you missed is, I don't even think you need a vaccine.
Me either. Right? That's what I'm saying, but don't say take the vaccine.
Stop. Yeah. And everybody, look at the chat. Everybody who's been following me will tell you, if you're going to wear a mask and wear a mask properly, if you're going to social distance and social distance properly, if you're going to quarantine and quarantine properly, if you do all those things, you don't need a mask.
I'm sorry.
You don't need a vaccine if you're going to do all that. You don't need a vaccine. But guess what? Ain't nobody doing that shit.
Yeah, people is eating the shit that you're saying, you know? Like,
did you hear what I just said, though?
Yeah, I agree with that.
And to me saying, hey, the reason I say take the vaccine is because it's at a point where you niggas don't want to do nothing else. You don't want to take. You don't want to wear a mask. You do not want to social distance. You do not want to quarantine properly. Niggas is going to work sick. Niggas is hanging with their homies sick. They know they sick. Won't tell their homie to after. Like, yeah, I was sick, bro. I just didn't think the shit would really affect you. You gonna be alright. You know how many niggas is sick because of niggas who did that to them? Right.
No, I definitely understand. But check this out. Why don't you just give a little advice, just like Nipsey did, and said, going on an alkaline diet may help you.
Blood.
You said that alkaline diets don't defeat diseases or don't work at all.
I'm telling you this, and I'm going to say it again. Alkaline diets are a myth. Alkaline isn't. Diets aren't. Everything that's in an alkaline diet, the shit that you have to do, drink water, right?
And yeah, but there's different types of water. Do you agree?
Let me finish. And eat vegetables and fruits is in every diet. That's not just in alkaline diets. Again, to remind
you. Is there different waters with different benefits? Yes or no? Alkaline water just has a higher pH level that's going to remove the acidity from your body because, like you said, everybody's eating potato chips, cookies, and all that shit.
Listen. What a lot of niggas understand is diet, right? You understand a diet, right? You know what a diet, right?
I just called it a diet. I'm just saying alkaline foods. Have you ever seen the alkaline list? You probably eat a lot of the foods that are on an alkaline list.
7:30, listen.
All I'm saying is you eat these foods, you're going to have a better chance. You're saying don't even eat them at all.
Alkaline, listen. Look, I called you alkaline. 7:30, listen. A lot of niggas know about diets. A lot of niggas know about foods. You know what a lot of niggas don't know shit about? Alkaline. Niggas don't know shit about it. They think they know about it through the foods. Nah, that ain't how that work. You don't learn what alkalinity is through alkaline foods. That's not how that shit works. I'm telling you, you can go look at any scientific or anything you want. The foods that you put into your body do not have the capacity to change your homeostasis pH level, period. And I remind you, your pH level, which is your balance between alkaline and acidity. If it was 8.8, if it was this, if your body was the pH level that's in this water that you're drinking, that I drink,
yeah,
we would be dead.
Can you prove that? No cap, you're not lying. Because if you eat too much, you can die.
If you eat too much, you can die. Now watch this. You telling brothers and sisters to eat an alkaline diet, right? That means everything.
To implement it in their life. You can continue eating whatever you want to eat. Okay.
Now here's what
if you put some of them shits in there, you could balance the shit out.
Okay. Here's what I said. There are people who try to live a purely alkaline lifestyle, right? What did you just say? If your pH balance.
My mistake.
Now, just remind you, imagine somebody every meal and every drink that they take has an alkaline level of 8.8. What the fuck do you think is going to happen?
No, they would die. You're right. I forgot about that. So my mistake. So if you do, but you know, like, I don't know. Are you telling people not to eat anything alkaline or don't eat alkaline food? You know, that was what I was going crazy about. You feel me?
What I'm telling people first is that an alkaline diet is a myth. What I'm also telling people is that everything that's in an alkaline diet that people praise to be like, hey, man, this is how alkaline diet is drinking water and eating fruits and vegetables.
Yeah.
That's in every diet.
Absolutely.
Right? What I tell people is, hey, man, fuck all these diets. Here's something real simple that you can do. Right? If you're a fat nigga, you trying to get healthy or you trying to come back from diabetes or you just don't like your quality of life, I guarantee you that you got a whole bunch of sugar in your motherfucking house. I guarantee.
No, that's a fact. And you did, you know, I do agree with what you said, that if you just remove a bunch of shit that you're normally doing, like eating the snacks, the sugars, and you remove the sugars and all that shit, you know, you'll be in good shape. You know what I'm saying?
That's it. That's all I said. So what is this? What is this? You a white man in a black man's body? You with the niggas that killed Kobe? You motherfucker? This we don't fight. And I'm like, what's all that shit, bro?
My bad, bro. You know what I mean? That's a little shock value and shit, but that's how I felt at the time. You feel me? But my apologies.
I appreciate you, 7:30.
No doubt, bro. Anytime. I wasn't on the camera because I'm working and shit at the same time.
I hear you. I'm mad at that. Shout out to the little one in the background doing his thing, man. And you be blessed and be good out here, bro.
All right, my brother.
All right, peace.
Have a good one.
I'm going to say this, and I'm going to say this the last time, and then I'm getting up out of here. My track record is flawless. Every nigga that comes to me like that winds up, we leave out. Actually, fuck it. I ain't even finna get into that. Shout out to my homie 7:30. Shout out to everybody on the chat. Again, my proofs are in the puddings of what the fuck I be saying. I let this sit, let it settle, so you can. That's right. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Let consume it. You observed it. Peep it, swallow it, feel it, mm-hmm, yeah, see it, taste it, understand. You just saw it. What you just saw was what you just saw. No CGI, no Penn and Teller magic tricks. Lupe, don't forget that you said Zionists run the music industry. I've never said that. Never said Zionists run the music industry. It's a bunch of Jews who run that motherfucker, but that don't necessarily mean that they Zionist, right? But it's also a bunch of black niggas that run this shit too, right? It's a mix, right? But I've never said Zionists run the music business. That's some anti-Semitic shit. I'm just making an observation of the religious and ethnic background of the niggas who were my bosses. That's all I'm doing. Let me calm myself. Did you have to sell your soul? Let's get some soul sellers in here. Let's get down to the people who think I've sold my soul. I'm interested in that. Do you think, Lupe, did you sell your soul? I don't think I sold my soul. She not gonna come in. Who else? You should put this on Twitch so people can say you. The Zionist phase is anti-Semitic because there's Jews who don't believe in Zionism. They don't abide by it. They may profit off the fruits of Zionism, but they don't necessarily agree with it, and they don't align with it, or its principles or the things that it portrays. So you can't, to make that equation of that, you have to be very particular, which I try and do. Zionist is one kind of mentality that runs through a certain strain in the Jewish community, but it isn't the end all be all of all Jews. A lot of Jews don't want to live in Israel. Like they're not about that. They're not about the whole go to the homeland situation. There's a divide between American Jews, Israeli Jews, European Jews, Russian Jews. Like people kind of get in where they fit in. I think everybody kind of aligns around the history of it and certain aspects of it, but they don't all agree. Period. I'm still trying to understand this soul, my soul piece that people like to throw up. You don't like needles? I mean, you get vaccinated with the nose thing. You don't necessarily need the needle. I'd rather have the needles because it gets right into the bloodstream. You refuse to sell your soul. That's why you washed. That's funny. Niggas confuse a fucked up haircut with being broke, I guess. Damn, I didn't know that was the case. But I guess I'll take it. All right. What about the esoteric people? What do you mean, esoteric people? I know a lot of well-off niggas with fucked up haircuts. Even after they go to the barber shop, they like, yeah, I'm going to go and get cut up. You go and they go and they're like, you still look fucked up just a little bit. You might want to just go on, give up, man. Go on, just let that go, man. They're just holding on for their life. Yeah, I don't know what that means. I'll just stick to the questions. Okay, Usman, shout out to Usman. What's a good, healthy, balanced diet, Dan? A good, healthy, balanced diet is exactly what that is, a diet of balance, right? And you got to look at diet, not just what you do in a day, but what you do in a week, and make sure that your week is balanced. And understand that you can't underestimate the power of sugar. You can't underestimate the power of some of these highly concentrated products that we eat, that I still eat. Nigga, when I get up from this, I'm going to go get another butter covered in chocolate, right? That's what's finna happen. I got a Gatorade. I'm going to slam that. I got some other little situations, nigga. Listen, I'm not... My mind is on like, hey, but be careful. You know, make sure that you kind of balancing things out, or you making sure that you're spacing out things and stuff like that. So I'm on it. But nigga, I'm going to drink a Gatorade today that's full of sugar, my nigga. Like, I'm going to do that. But I'm also trying to drink a whole bunch of water on top of that too. So, but just understand, it's really balancing it out in a serious way, taking in consideration what you take into your body, not just on a daily basis, but also on a weekly basis. And then hopefully you can expand that into a bi-weekly basis, or, you know, 2 weeks or 3 weeks or a month. And eventually get to a point where you recognize how much you consume and what you consume within a year. Right. And then you can realize, okay, certain things that need to be absolutely removed from your diet, like processed meats and, you know, all of that stuff. And understand that, man, you can't eat a can of soup, but it's like the soup in the can, the meat is not processed, it's just chopped up. And that, you know, processing means that you take all this meat and mix it together and put salt in it and make something else out of it, where it didn't naturally come out of the body of the animal like that, for the sake of preserving it or something like that. So it's just certain things that just need to kind of be removed from your diet, or just subtly kind of hinted at and put in from time to time. And, you know, it's really that, man. It ain't I'm gonna go drink a gallon of motherfucking alkaline water a day. Appreciate that. Brother Lupe, some of us have been taking this virus situation very seriously and definitely been wearing masks and social distancing. Some of us been hearing you loud and clear. I appreciate you, brother. The folks who know, who come to my chats, they know who I'm talking to. They know who I'm talking to. And the folks who are in my chats, they also know when I'm talking to them and when I'm not talking to them. So I'm bussing blindly, but not really. Like, I'm looking at who I'm shooting at. So. Do we need to drink as much water as they say? Nah, not really. You piss a lot of water out. You do need to drink water, like, for sure. Do you need to drink like all kinds of water? There's not even real science on that. And again, each body is going to deal with water intake differently. You definitely can tell if you're dehydrated. And, you know, sometimes you drink definitely when you're thirsty, but it's also good to drink at points in time when you're not thirsty, just to kind of make sure, you know, your body will tell you when you need to drink water, for sure. You might get a little queasy, like some nausea, something like that, other aspects. So just, you know, keep a nice, don't kill yourself trying to drink a bunch of water, bro. Like, you know, and just know. That's all. Your body will tell you, but make sure that you're listening. That's that other piece. Make sure that you're actually listening to your body. Your body will tell. People survived so long, and people say, listen to your body. Like, yeah, that's listen to it, but listen to it. Like, don't ignore it, right? Because motherfuckers listen and then ignore. You can listen to a motherfucker out there and be like, I heard one, but fuck all that. Like, you listen and obey, right? So, yeah, listen, but then also do what your body is asking you to do. It's just not enough to just, well, I listen to my body and that's all I need to do. Like, no, nigga, you need to get up and go walk around, or you need to get up and go drink some water, like what I'm about to do. So coronavirus is still a thing. Make sure that you're practicing physical distancing. Make sure you wear a mask that covers the mouth and the nose. Condolences to the folks who passed during this time. Our prayers with you and your family. If you're sick, hope you're on the road to recovery and getting better. House EP and Tape Tape. House EP is myself and Kayla Ellis. Tape Tape is myself and Soundtrack. Both EPs are available right now. You can go to Spotify and Apple Music and all that to pick up copies. Make sure that you subscribe to the Lupe and Royce Show, the official podcast from Lupe Fiasco and Royce the 5'9". Imagine that. Two of the best MCs getting together to get on a podcast. It's the official podcast. It's available right now at saywhat.media, or you can get it wherever you get your podcast from the most part. So Google Podcasts, Spotify Podcasts, Apple Podcasts, we own there. So make sure you go check us out. Subscribe, leave a comment, let us know what you think about the episodes. We drop new episodes every Thursday. So make sure you tune into that. Appreciate everybody who's rocked with us thus far. We got merch available for the show, for the Lupe and Royce t-shirts. Make sure you get some of those. Also, we got new Lupe Fiasco merch at lupefiasco.com. So you go shop.lupefiasco.com. We got new hoodies, brand new designs, shirts that we never even made before. So there's finally a Food and Liquor t-shirt for the Food and Liquor album that you can get. We got cool hats, and we got house hoodies and tape t-shirts, and there's a daydreaming hoodie. So man, make sure that you check out shop.lupefiasco.com and get you the new Lupe merch over there as well. So I mean, that's it, man. I hope this added value, and that's all I got to say. You feel me? Peace.